Hello, I'm Mr. R. Mitchell, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to describe that how the after the death of St. James the Just in Jerusalem, the next bishop, or next people of the in the Church of God, which were mostly Jewish people, Messianic. So the next bishop who was in the Church of God, he got frightened of the Jews. And to please them, he bring in their Torah, or bring in their practices, which is the written Torah, which was rotten old cloth, which was not good for, which was good for nothing, and which the bishop, church bishop, like Saint Stephen, he was giving the rectified version of this written Torah. So when these, the next bishop became corrupt, he bringing the written Torah wholesale, wholesome, so without rectification. And the apostles, who were mainly the Gentile, or the Jewish also, they used to rebuke the bishop for his malpractice, for bringing in this written Torah. So he was sycophant, the bishops. You know, this is the age of sycophants, clever people. So he was sycophant. So he got the gathering of the people in the church. Now, in Jesus, we do not have disciples, we have workers and laborers. Remember at the Samaritan village, Jesus said, oh, the crop is white, ripe, ready to be harvested. Father, send more laborers into your field. So in Christ Jesus, we are laborers and workers. We are not disciples. In John the Baptist had disciples, not Jesus. Jesus picked up the everyone. You come, you come. Not that anybody could join Jesus in the closer circle. So these bishops then became corrupt. They started making disciples. And when they bring in this written Torah, in the written Torah, Yahweh is the Lord. He is not the same Father. He is not the same as God. God is spirit. God is spirit that sets you free. But Yahweh is Lord, who is jealous and revengeful, just the opposite of our Father in spirit. So Yahweh is a Lord. So the Jewish Messianic Jew, they start to call even Jesus a Lord, and also our Father, which is Spirit, they start to call him a Lord too. Lord binds you. Spirit sets you free. So neither Jesus wanted to bind us, nor our Father is seeking to bind us. So who is Lord among them? Neither Jesus nor our Father God. So only the Lord exists in the kingdom of Satan. Because in the kingdom of Satan, you have no free will. As these Messianic Jews later became, and those who are not obeying them, who are not reading the Old Testament, or who did not include the Old Testament in their Bible, they were put before animals to be eaten alive. So I will describe these things in detail later on. So here I just want to stress the situation that was created by these corrupt bishops. So the Christianity became corrupt soon after the death of Jesus and after the death of Saint James the Just. The corruption start creeping in. And the apostle used to rebuke them. So the bishop said, if you want to come into my church, don't rebuke me. Do what I tell you to do. The apostle said, our praises lie with our Father God, into whose service we are putting ourselves, and not in your service. So you are not our master. Our master is our Father. We are working for him and not for you. So they refused to accept the plea of the bishops and told them, if you are not amending your behavior or antichrist activities, then we are no more coming into the churches. So they left the churches and opened monasteries. Whereas these Messianic Jews, then they bring in the malpractices. They were worse than those from which our brother Christ Jesus set us free. So these Messianic Jews became the cruel master in the name of Jesus. So they addressed him as Lord so that they can lord over the people. And they were sycophant. Remember, the sycophant are those who render praises to the people, who are very humble soothsayer. Gospel, those people who preach gospel, they are not soothsayer. They are very bitter speaker, because gospel truth is bitter. Such as, I tell them that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. Not everybody can take it. And those who understand it, that Jew is a spiritual self and not the physical self, when I explain to them, they understand it, but they dare not open their mouth in case they are challenged. So such is the nature of gospel. So when you want to preach gospel, you have to be very open-minded and not to be close-minded and not to seek the praises of men, but go straight path. Do not twist around. It's the narrow road that you are following. In that narrow road is straight. It has no bends. So if you start taking bends, then you go astray from this path. Once you go astray, then you find yourself very difficult to go back onto the path, because you told lies to the people. You became a sycophant. You rendered praises to the people. Now how can you reverse your saying, what came out of your mouth? No way. So the path which is of God is straight and it's very sharp. That means you cannot twist around or you cannot go astray. You have to please Father and not the people. So you have to be impartial. You have not to take the side. As soon as you take the side, you become partial, then you are off the way, or you have entered into the kingdom of Satan. So it becomes difficult for you to go back to the royal kingdom of God. So remember this doubting stage. Many people at doubting stage, these Messianic Jews, they were of doubting stage, who went for Mammon instead of for God. And in the name of Mammon, they start fleecing people and Pope is the ultimate.